Okay. So, so far we discussed about different types of conventional materials used in engineering applications. So, you know, the most important conventional material used in any of the engineering application is steel and or other ferrous materials. But the main problem of this ferrous and non-ferrous materials is there are some limitations in the property. We cannot use this type of material for high-end technology applications. So metallurgists day-to-day inventing different types of material which can be used for high-end technology engineering applications. So from this lecture we are going to study about this type of modern material which is used nowadays for engineering application. So the first material is ceramics. So you may heard about the ceramics commonly in our kitchen. We use ceramic materials like crockery items. So these are the ceramic material. So from the kitchen, this ceramic materials application range is to very high-end technologies. For example, we use a ceramic material for machining, and we use ceramic material for that is to cover the important engine parts of the missiles, aircraft, we use in atomic reactor. So everywhere we use ceramic material. So in this lecture we are going to study about this ceramic material. So what is the meaning of ceramic material? Ceramic comes from the Greek word keramikos, which means burnt stuff, indicating that desirable property of these materials are normally achieved through high temperature heat treatment process called firing. So the most common example for the ceramic material is brick. You know how this brick is produced. We use clay, and by using some forming process we shape the clay, and then after firing or after heating, the deformable clay or elastic clay material is hardened. Okay, we got a very strong hard brick from the clay. So firing is essential. Okay, so in ceramic material, by the application of high temperature heat treatment process, we got high strength and hardness ceramic material. So the meaning is also that is burnt stuff. Okay, and most of the ceramic compounds between these are the compounds between metallic and non-metallic element for which interatomic bonds are either ionic or predominantly ionic but having some covalent character. So this is the compound between metallic and non-metallic elements. You know, in the periodic table there is a specific area for metallic elements and a specific area for non-metallic element. So there will be ionic bonding. Most commonly the ionic bonding is established between this metallic and non-metallic elements, and the ceramics are formed. So we will discuss about this in detail. So what are the properties of ceramics compared to metals, steel, aluminium, copper? There are different types of metal. So what are the important properties when compared to these metals? The ceramic materials are extremely hardness. It has extreme hardness. Okay, that is a very important property. This extreme hardness property helps to use the ceramic materials for the machining applications. It can be used for grinding, it can be used for making different tools, etc. So it has very high wear resistance. Okay, so because of the high hardness, and it reduces the friction. Okay, so we can use the ceramic material for ball bearings. So by the extreme hardness, the wear resistance, it offers a wear resistance during the mating time. Okay, second one, it has good corrosion resistance. So we can use in any salt environment or any corroded environment, we can use ceramic material. It has high heat resistance and electrical conduct resistance also. So we know our electrical fuses are made with the ceramic material. So what is the reason? It has very, very low electrical conductivity. And thermal conductivity is also low for ceramic material. Thermal flasks are made with the ceramic material. And low thermal expansion. So because of the low thermal expansion, we use ceramic material to seal this furnace wall of the seal the furnace wall. And poor thermal shock resistance also is a property of the ceramic material. But it has very low ductility. That is the main problem of the ceramic material. It has very low ductility. It has brittleness nature. So that is why when we drop a crockery item, it suddenly fails without any permanent deformation. Okay, so it's very brittle in nature, and a high elastic modulus also another property. And it has very low toughness. That is also a disadvantage for ceramic material. The energy absorbing property of the ceramic material is very low. And low density. So porosity affects the property. In ceramic material, and there are lots of porous space. So it has very low density. And high strength, but it has very high strength at elevated temperature. So we can use the ceramic material parts in the elevated temperature regions like missiles, engines, etc. So it maintain high strength at elevated temperature without any deformation and failure. So these are the properties of the ceramic material. So compared to the property difference between ceramic material and metal and polymers, we can see the hardness is very high for ceramic, but ductility is very low, very high wear resistance, very high corrosion resistance, thermal and electrical conductivities are very low for ceramic material. So what are ceramic? Well, this is a compound between metallic and non-metallic elements. The compound formation is basic mainly because of the ionic bonding. And these are the silicates. It can be a silicate or oxide, nitrate and carbon. Typically insulative to the passage of electricity and heat, we already discussed that. More resistance to high temperature and harsh environment than metal and polymers. Okay, for example, corrosive and acidic environment also, it offer more resistance. And it is very hard and brittle. We can see the example Al2O3, NaCl, SiZ, SiO2, all these are the examples of ceramic material. So, coming in detail about ceramic structure, crystal structure of the ceramic material. In ceramic material, we have a cation and anion. So it is a ceramic material is a compound that is formed between the metallic element and non-metallic element. And the compound bonding is commonly is an ionic bonding. Okay, so when a ionic bonding happens, then there will be a cation and an anion. So the cation has a positive charge, okay, because they have given up their valence electron to non-metallic ion. So by donating a valence electron, the one atom changes to the metallic ion changes to cation, which has positive charge. And another one is anion, which accept the valence electron, and which the anion has a negative charge. So in a ceramic material, that is a compound, in that we can see anion and cation. Cation has positive charge and anion has negative charge. And the two characteristics of the compound ion in the crystalline ceramic materials influence the crystal structures. What are they? The magnitude of electrical charge on each component ion. So in this case, here in this CaF2 ceramic compound, we can see F minus and Ca2 plus are the two ions, cation and anion. So this charge, the minus and 2 plus charge, influence the characteristics of the ceramic material. And second characteristics, the relative size of the cation and anion. So the ratio of RC by RA, the ratio of cation and anion, is another influencing factor which affect the characteristics of the ceramic material. So with respect to the first characteristic, the ceramic material should be electrically neutral. So number of positive ion and the number of positive charge and a negative charge should be equal. So there should be a balance between the anion and the cation charges. And second condition, that is the relative size. The chemical formula of the compound indicate the ratio of cation to anion or the composition that achieve this charge balance. So this is the two important factors or characteristics. First one is the electrical charge of anion and cation should be balanced, and the cation anion size, relative size, also an important factor. So one of the example of the ceramic material, the calcium fluoride. In this calcium fluoride, we have two ions, cation and anion, the positively charged cation and negatively charged anion, CF minus and Ca2 plus. And this form a compound, that is an ionic compound, CaF2. Okay, so this is an example for ceramic material. And here the charge is balanced, the negative and the positive charge is balanced here. And the second criteria which we discuss is the ratio of the size of the cation and anion. So cation anion, we can measure the radius of the cation and anion. So the ionic radius of the cation and anion is RC and RA. Okay, so RC is the radius of the cation and RA is the radius of the anion. So because the metallic element give up electron when anodized, cations are ordinarily smaller than that of anion. What is the reason? Because cation donating the electrons, valence electron, into anion. So always this cation, the valence, because of the removal of the valence electron, cation will be smaller than that of anion. So this ratio RC by RA is will be always less than unity. It will be always less than unity because of the smaller size of cation than when compared to anion. So see this. This is the arrangement of atoms. This is a stable arrangement of atom. Here the bigger one is cation and red color. Red color bigger one is cation and the blue color smaller one is anion. Sorry. Blue circle denotes cation. Sorry, blue circle denotes cation and the red color represent the anion. So these two are the stable condition, because here we can see the anion and cations are there is a contact between each other, but here this is an unstable condition because of the there is no contact between anion and cation. So what is the coordination number? We already discussed what is coordination number in the atomic arrangement. Here also a coordination number. It is nothing but it is the number of anion nearest neighbors for the cation. So it is related to the cation anion ratio, radius ratio. So when we measure the ratio of the cation RC and measure the radius of the anion and RA, so RC by RA is the cation anion ratio, and this ratio has an influence on the coordination number. What is coordination number? Number of anion nearest neighbor for the cation. Okay, so this coordination number and RC by RA ratio have a relationship. So we will discuss the relationship in the next slide. So this is the relationship. Okay, so here in this we can see there are two anion and one cation. Okay, so here in this, what is the ratio? By measuring the radius of the cation and anion, we can measure the RC and RA value, and RC by RA, that is a cation anion ratio. When it is less than 0.155, cation is very smaller here compared to anion. So this will be very less. So it is less than 0.155. Then coordination number will be 2. That means the number of atom in contact is only 2. Okay. So when these atoms are arranged like a triangle, here the number of anion is 3 and a single cation. So cation to anion ratio, again here it is 0.155 to 0.225. So here the radius ratio is increased from this case. So at the same time, for this range, if the radius ratio is in between these two limiting ratio, then the cation coordination number will be 3. And here we can see 4 anion and 1 cation. Cation is at the center. This is the radius ratio. Corresponding coordination number will be 4. Similarly, this one and this one. So we have coordination number 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. So based on the atomic radius ratio RC by RA, we can calculate the coordination number. In most of the case, this relationship, the cation anion radius ratio and the coordination number is valid. So this is an important point. So the coordination number and the nearest geometries for various RC by RA ratio is present in this table. The ratio less than 0.155. The very small cation is bonded with the two anion in a linear manner. This is a linear manner. And this RC by RA has a value between 0.155 to 0.225. So the coordination number here it is 3. In case of the triangular arrangement. So this means that the cation is surrounded by 3 anion in the form of a planar equilateral triangle with the cation located at the center. The next one, RC by RA ratio is 0.225 to 0.414. Corresponding coordination number will be 4. So the coordination number is 4 for this range, and the cation is located at the center of the tetrahedron, anion at each of the 4 corners. The next one is 0.414 to 0.732. This is the coordination number. And the next one, the coordination number is 8. Okay, so these are the arrangement of cation and anion, corresponding coordination number and radius ratio. So there are two main points. First one is the magnitude of electrical charges of each ion. That is an important factor which influence the property of the ceramics. First one, the charge balance detects in the chemical formula Ca2 plus F minus for CaF2. So that is the first characteristic. Second one is the radius ratio RC by RA, which is always less than 1 because of the RC, the size of the cation always less than size of the anion. So RC by RA will be always less than 1, and which is also another factor which will influence the property of the ceramic. We already discussed these two points in detail. And there are different type of crystal arrangement for ceramics. So the first one is AX type of crystal arrangement. For example, the famous example is NaCl. NaCl. So Na plus and Cl minus. So in this Na is the one atom. So we can generally we can say Na is equal to A. Okay. And second one is Cl chlorine. Then Cl we can generally say X. So all the in this example we can see there is no subscript terms here. NaCl, MgO, MnS, etc. So this is a general crystal structure for all this type of compounds. But here in this case, another case we can take AmXp. So another type of crystal structure. For example, Zr O2. So Zr is corresponding to A. M is here it is 1. P is equal to 2. Okay, so this is another type of crystal structure. So in this AX type, the example is NaCl. So this is the figure showing the NaCl unit cell. So in this NaCl unit cell, that is actually generated from the FCC crystal structure arrangement. Okay, it is not exactly FCC crystal structure, but it is developed from the, it is generated from the FCC arrangement of anions with the one cation situated at the cube center and one at the center of each of the 12 cube edges. So where this cation is present, the smaller one is cation Na plus. We can see the Na plus at the at the center of the each of the 12 cube edges. So we can see that this is a cube edge. So at the center we can see this cation. And at the same time, we can see at the okay, so at the center we can see the center of the edge, we can see the cation. And where we can find the anion? This at the face ends, we can see the, and at the edges also we can see the, not at the edge, just in the corner. Okay, the green color Cl minus can be seen in the corners and face ended. Okay, so an equivalent crystal structure results from the face ended arrangement of the cation. So here the cations are arranged like a face ended. It's an example, famous example of NaCl. So here we do two interplanetary FCC crystal structures, one composed of the cation and other with the anion. So here actually we interpenetrated two FCC lattice structure. One is composed with the cation, another composed with the anion. So this is an example for AX type crystal structure. Another, so first example is NaCl, rock salt, for this AX type crystal structure. And second example is cesium chloride structure. So this is a cesium chloride structure, again A for CS, B for Cl. Okay, cesium chloride. So this is the arrangement of cesium chloride, and here at the center we can see cesium cation, and the chlorine ions can be seen at the edges. But this is not an FCC crystal structure, sorry, BCC crystal structure, because for a BCC crystal structure, every particle should be same, it should be an atom, then only we can say that is a BCC crystal structure. But here we can see at the corner points we can see Cl minus, and at the center we can see another ion Cs plus. So we cannot see this is a BCC crystal structure. So here anions are located at the corners and cation is at the center. So that is another example, cesium chloride structure. So next crystal structure is AMXP type. AMXP type, for example, the calcium fluoride is an example for this AMXP type. Here M and P will not be equal to 1. So this is example fluoride, the Ca for A, F 2, that means this P equal to 2. So in this we have two ions, the Ca 2 plus cation and F minus anion. And how this arrangement, the CaF2, this is the arrangement of CaF2. In CaF2 arrangement, it is similar to CaCl, except that only half the center of the cube positions are occupied Ca2 plus ion. So it is almost similar to this CaCl. Okay, that means BCC. It's almost similar to BCC, but it is not a BCC. So this crystal structure is almost similar to this one. But what is the difference? In this, only half the center of the cube is positions are occupied Ca2+. So here we have, we can take a one cube from, there are, this is composed of 8 cube. So we can take one cube, so this one, okay, this ion, this one, 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 so this is a cube. Divided in this unit cell into 8, then one part will be a cube. And actually this center Ca2 plus is not belong to this cube. Okay, so this half of this Ca2 plus is belong to this cube, and another next half is shared with this cube, the adjacent cube. So that is actually explained here. The only half the center of the cube positions are occupied by Ca2 plus ion. So example is ZrO2, UO2, PuO2, etc. AMXP type. Next type is AMBMXP type. So here in this, we have more than one type of cation. The cation will be more than one type and one anion. So this is an example, BaTiO3, SiZrO2, etc. So barium tritonate, BaTiO3, have Ba2 plus, Ta4 plus cation. Both are cation. And one O anion, oxygen anion. So this material has a perovskite crystal structure, rather interesting electrochemical properties. And at the temperature above 120 degrees Celsius, a crystal structure will be cubic. The unit cell of the structure is shown in the figure. This is the unit cell of the barium tritonate. In this unit cell, we can see at the edges, at the corner points, we can see Ba2 plus. At the face end, we can see O2 minus. And at the body center, we can see Ta4 plus. So this is the arrangement of BaTiO3, an example for AMBMXP type. So this is the summary of all the different type of crystal structure. The rock salt and cesium chloride are AX type crystal structure. And atomic packing is FCC and a simple cubic. Number of cation and a number of anion is also given. Example of the corresponding crystal structure is NaCl and CaCl. So similarly, different types of structure name and the corresponding structure type is explained here. So BaTiO3, the perovskite, that is AMBNXP type. So that is about the three type of crystal structures, AX type and AMXP type, AMBMXP type. So next is types and application of ceramics. Ceramics is used in very different application, different engineering applications. So basically ceramics is classified into glass, clay products, refractory items, abrasive items, cements, and advanced ceramics. So this is the initial classification of the ceramics based on the application point of view. And glass is again divided into glasses and glass ceramics. Clay is divided into structural and vias, etc. And refractory is classified into fire clay, silica, basic and special. And there are different types of abrasives, cements, and advanced ceramics like MEMS and optical fiber, etc. So this is the different classification of ceramic materials based on the application. So this is the spectrum of the ceramics. We can see the classification. So in your day-to-day life, we use ceramic material for different application. We can make abrasive, we can make flooring tiles and cement bricks, then the crockery item, and structural clay product, gear, engineering ceramic material applications. So everywhere we use ceramic material. So the classification is, the first one is glass and second one is glass ceramics. So you know what is glass is nothing but it is a non-crystalline silicate that containing oxides. So this CO, N2O, K2O, Al2O3, which influence the glass properties. And that is a familiar group of ceramics. What are the uses of our application of these glasses? We can make containers. We can make lenses, fiber glasses, etc. using glass ceramics. The second one is glass ceramic. So what is the difference between glass and glass ceramic? Most of the inorganic glass that is made with the silica can be made to transform from non-crystalline. So this is a non-crystalline. The ordinary glass is a non-crystalline silicate. It is containing non-crystalline silicate. So when we make a glass ceramic, what we do? We transform from non-crystalline silicate stage to one that crystalline by proper high temperature heat treatment. So we convert the non-crystalline ceramic into crystalline ceramic by some heat treatment and produce glass ceramic. So this process is called crystallization, and the product will be finer grained polycrystalline material, which is often used as a glass ceramics. We use glass ceramic for ovenware, tableware, oven windows, and the range tops primarily because of their strength and excellent resistance to thermal shock. So third one, so this is the different types of ceramics. So the main component is nothing but silicate, and other components are also added to improve the properties and the characteristics and application of each ceramics is explained here. Another one is the clay products. So you know how can we make different products using clay. So this is a very inexpensive ingredient. So it is abundantly available in our nature. And it is mined without any upgrading of quality. Another reason for its popularity is by which the clay products may be formed. When mixed in proper proportion, clay and water form a plastic mass that is very amenable or to shape. The formed pieces are then dried or fired to remove some moisture, after which it is fired at elevated temperature to improve its mechanical strength. So that is the making of the ordinary clay products. So there are different applications for the clay products, which are clay products and white wares. This is a white ware. Is used for different application. What are the different applications? Structural clay produce building bricks, tile and sewer pipes, etc. And the white wares. It's another type of clay product. Structural clay product and white wares. Both are different. So white wares ceramics is used for the high-end application like pottery, tableware, china, plates, and plumbing fixtures, etc. For sanitary ware, etc., we use the second type of ceramic. Another one is refractory materials made with the ceramics. The silent properties of these materials include the capacity to withstand very high temperature without melting and decomposing, and the capacity to remain unreactive and inert when exposed to severe environment. And it provides thermal insulation. Refractory materials are marked with very variety of forms, but bricks are most commonly used one. Typical application include furnace lining of metals, refining, glass manufacturing, metallurgical heat treatment, and power generation. So everywhere we use refractory materials. So these are the different types of refractory materials. You know the main constituent is L2O3 and SiO2. Then abrasive ceramics. We use ceramic material for abrasive machining operation. So you know the abrasive wheels and the sandpaper, etc. So where we use ceramic material. And this abrasive used in several forms, bonded to grinding wheel, coated with abrasives and our loose grained material. So the grain we can coat or bonded to the grinding wheel. That is one method. Another one is coated with abrasive. So we are not bonded with the grinding wheel. It is coated with the abrasive. And the third one is loose grains of abrasive. These loose grains are actually used for used along with the oil, etc., to remove the and polish the surface or to improve the surface finish of the material. So diamond, silicon carbide, tungsten carbide, ornamentum and silica sand are the most common example for this type of abrasive ceramic. We can use different methods. We can either bond it to the abrasive wheel or we can coat it on the paper or fabric. So I am not going to explain these terms cement. So you, everyone is familiar with the cement. So that is also a type of ceramic material. And main characteristics of cement is when it is mixed with the water, they form a base and subsequent set and hardness is improved. So that is about cement. That is also ceramic material. So next one is advanced ceramic material. There are different types of advanced ceramic materials are used for modern technological application, and the main properties of the ceramics is very useful for manufacturing different components in the modern engineering systems. The first one is MEMS system, so micro electromechanical system. In MEMS system, that is a smart system. It consists of the sensors, micro actuators, micro sensors, etc. So micro sensors collect the data, and the micro sensors collect environmental information by measuring the mechanical, thermal, electrical, chemical, optical magnetization phenomena, and the micro electronic components, and then process this sensor input and subsequent render decision, that is direct response from the micro actuators. So here are micro actuators also used. So to make this MEMS system, we can use ceramics. Optical fiber is made with extremely high purity silica. So what is advanced is the free of even minutes level of containers and the defects that absorb, scatter and attenuate a light beam. So we can make a optical fibers using ceramic. Third one is ceramic ball bearing. The silicon nitride ball bearing offer very high hardness and which is useful for the this ceramic ball bearing is can be used for specific activity. The piezoelectric ceramics. So you know what is piezoelectric effect. By the application of strain energy, we can produce electricity. So the few ceramic materials exhibit the unusual phenomena of piezoelectricity. Electric polarization is induced into the ceramic crystal when a mechanical strain is imposed on it. There are different examples: barium titanate, PbTO3, lead titanate. These are the examples for psychometric material. So that is the modern one, another modern material applications of ceramics. So we can see the engine rotor made with ceramic material, gears made with ceramic material, and in the ceramic disc brake is used to reduce the wear resistance. So that is about the ceramic material.